Hey Siri, play Follow God by Kanye West.
Follow God by Kanye West now playing.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Naseem here, aka Seema Dream, aka Nastech, and today I will be reviewing the very cute, the very small Apple HomePod Mini. And if I'm being truly honest with you guys, I was very excited when I first got my hands on the HomePod Mini for the simple fact that this is the very first time that I had my hands on an Apple speaker. But before we get into more details, let's just unbox this thing. The HomePod Mini comes in two different colors, you know, the most standard colors there are for any smart device, that being white and space gray. And it kind of surprised me that there weren't a great range of colors, because usually when it comes to cheaper devices in the Apple lineup, we usually get the most colors, but this time it wasn't the case, which is very unfortunate. And if I'm being honest with you guys, I was very surprised when I didn't see a great range of colors, because you know Apple, whenever there is a cheaper version of, you know, their flagship product, they usually just provide us with many more colors, you know, just the very colorful colors, you know, like green, blue, sometimes product red, etc. And even though it's unfortunate, it is not a deal breaker, for the simple fact that the reason we get a speaker is to listen to some music. And now for the controls. When you tap it once, that enables play or pause. When you tap it twice, it enables skip. And when you tap it three times, it enables you to go back. And last but not least, when you press and hold it, it connects you to Siri. And when it comes to the size of the HomePod Mini, we have a tiny little speaker that stands at 3.3 inches high and weighs 0.76 pounds with a width of 3.9 inches wide. And when it comes to the HomePod Mini, I really feel like that was one of the main features to discuss, while also being almost the best feature to discuss, because having that portability and such a quality speaker is such a quality feature to have. And now, as far as sound, it was pretty good for a mini speaker, as I would say. Like, you know, when I was using it outside versus in the house, I really couldn't tell that much of a difference. You know, it was very great in that aspect. But one thing that I kind of wish it was a little louder, but that kind of comes with smaller speakers. And although it couldn't do as many great things because it was very limited due to its size, I honestly still feel like this is the best small speaker of 2020. And that is pretty much all I had to say about the HomePod Mini. And if you were thinking about purchasing the HomePod Mini, I would definitely say this is a go. The portability is unbeatable. It has great speakers, sort of limited, but still great speakers. And I honestly feel like this was a great time that I had with this device. So if you guys like my review on the HomePod Mini, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe, show as much support to the channel as you can. It's very appreciated. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.